Hi, this presentation is about using Canvas to give in-class exams. This particular part is going to focus on creating an exam. Why would you want to do this? Well, when you use Canvas to give in-class exams, students do them on their own laptops or on their own tablets with a keyboard. This is great. Number one, the students type their essay answers, which makes them so much easier to read. Second, it provides a secure environment. The exams are automatically saved and they're regularly saved to the cloud. So you have, well, unless the internet goes down, but there's always that caution. What you have then is the ability to share exams with your graduate student teaching assistant and to save copies of them and any comments you make on them when you grade them so that you can see how a student progresses over the semester. So let's create an exam. In order to create an exam in Canvas, you have to start on your main page and then click on Quizzes in the menu on the left. When that shows up, click on the Add Quiz red button that's up on the upper right. This is a rather complicated slide, but there are various steps just to go through. First, name the exam. Second, choose graded quiz. This is, after all, going to be an exam that you're giving in the classroom. If you have an assignment group set up for exams, choose that. Shuffle answers if you have multiple choice questions and you want the answers in each question to appear in random order. And then finally, specify a time limit for the exam. Scroll down, because this is all on one page, so scroll down, and then you have some other options to choose. I suggest showing one question at a time on the screen. It allows students just to focus on that one question. Be sure to require a passcode or a password here, because that is what you will be using in the classroom when the students are ready to take the exam. You'll then give them the password and they'll be able to open it. Assign the exam to the class, and then fill in the due date and time. What I do is I put the due date as the end of class on the appropriate day, and then I start it or make it available fairly early in the morning on that day, and then have it again available until the end of the class on that day. After you have saved the exam setup, you need to add questions. Scroll back to the top of the page and click on the question button. Click on the Add New Question or the Add New Question Group button. If you are giving all of the students in the same questions in the same order, just add your questions. If you want the system to randomly assign students questions from a set of questions, or to randomize the order of the question shown, choose question group. For example, I give my students 5 essay questions in their exam study guide. The system then assigns one of the 5 to each student in the class. I will show how to work the rest of this session within a question group. Okay. So what you need to do is give the group a name, and then specify the number of questions to assign from the group. Fill in the number of points that each question is worth. For example, here I have an essay question. I'm going to have a group of 5 questions. I want the system to pick 1, and I want the essay to be worth 30 points. Then you create the group. Once you've created the group, you click on the tiny plus sign in the very top menu bar to add a question to the group. Choose the type of question you want to ask and give the question a name to identify the content. I haven't filled that out in this particular example here, but I have chosen essay question. Type the text for the essay question in the box. If you choose a different type of question, such as multiple choice or multiple selection, it will show a different screen and you'll simply fill in the required parts. Make sure to save the question. To add another question to the same group, click on the tiny plus in the group header. Then what you do is, again, fill in the question details and save it. If you want to add another question group, then simply go down to the bottom and click on the new question group slide. You might want to start a new group for another set of essays, short answer questions, identification, multiple choice, whatever. From the main page for the quiz, it's possible to use the preview function to have the exam show up on your screen, the questions in various orders. It's really helpful if you want to double check that you don't have typos or any other problems with the questions themselves. In this preview exam, the system has given me one of my set of essay questions, and it shows the text box that the student would use to answer the question, so I've started to answer it to try it out. At the end, you submit the quiz. The preview function doesn't save your answer, so you can't see what that looks like, but at least you can see what it's like to take your exam. Now here comes the harder part. You have to add the lockdown browser requirement in order to have these students take the exam in a classroom and not have any access to the internet or to other programs. I will go into more detail about how you set up the lockdown browser for your students in the second presentation in this series. But for right now, I'm assuming that you have the lockdown browser installed on your computer. And so you have to choose the lockdown browser from the main menu. That's way over on the left side. When you do that, then you get, the quizzes will show up on your screen. Click on the tiny menu bar to the left of your exam file. It is not intuitive. When you have done that, another screen will show and you have to add the settings. So here you have require the browser. You have lock the students in the browser until the exam is completed. And if any of your students are using iPads, you want to allow iPads. Now you'll see that there is a blank for password settings. I recommend that you keep this blank. You've already set the password along with the quiz settings. If you add the password here again, then if you change it in one place, you have to remember to change it in the other place. It doesn't change automatically both ways. When you have finished setting up the exam, publish it. This simply makes it show up on the students' screens. They can't access it. And you can always still edit it. So it's just, it's just the same. It just shows up for the students. So we're finished with this part. You've created an exam. And now what we're going to do in part two is I'm going to talk about giving the exam in class.